Hi, I'm Tinkerbell and I'm filming from a village called Tomioka. And Tomioka is located in Japan in Fukushima Prefecture, around 9 kilometers from the Fukushima Daiichi power plant. Let's see. So in the middle there's Fukushima Daiichi power plant, and just a little bit below there, that's Tomioka, and that's where I am right now. I think it's good to explain radiation first. I will explain in a very simple way, and when you know more about radiation you will say, oh, but it's more complicated than that. You're right, but the basics is correct. So there we go. This is a tennis ball, and I think almost everyone owns a tennis ball. There's probably a tennis ball in your house, and there might be more tennis balls in your house, right? So if you have a tennis ball in your house, then there is a slight chance of stumbling upon this tennis ball. You might fall. You even might fall that bad that you die. That is the risk of radiation. You know, a lot of people think that radiation is a gas, but that's not true. Radiation, it contains of little parts. These are just little parts. They're that little that you cannot see, smell, or feel them. But think of it as tennis balls. And every little part, or every part of radiation, is a chance, a possibility to stumble upon this tennis ball. If you think of it like that, the chances are very, very, very small. But think of, when you have two tennis balls, or maybe 10 or 100, then the risk increases. So the more tennis balls you have in your house, the higher the risk of stumbling upon one of these balls one day and maybe dying from the fall. That's how radiation works. When you hear there's radiation somewhere, it's very important that you know how much radiation there is, but it still doesn't mean that it will have any effect on you, because even if you have 100,000 tennis balls in your house, it doesn't mean they will kill you. It just increases the chance of stumbling upon a tennis ball, and that is how radiation works. So when you think of a tennis ball as a radioactive part, I am now radioactive because there's a radioactive part on me or in my hand, right? But that means that you can move it. Now I'm not radioactive anymore. And that's basically one of the things they are doing in Fukushima, Japan, in the past 7.5 years. They are trying to move parts, radioactive parts, to lower the radioactive level.
Well, easy peasy, right?